नमस्कार। देश की सबसे बड़ी पंचायत में जनहित के मुद्दों पर होने वाली चर्चा पर आधारित कार्यक्रम संसद संवाद में आप सभी का स्वागत है। मैं हूं प्रीति सिंह। सरकारी कल्याण योजनाओं का लाभ लाभार्थियों तक सीधा पहुंचाने वाले आधार या वित्तीय और अन्य सब्सिडी लाभ और सेवाओं का लक्षित वितरण विधेयक 2016 राज्यसभा में धन संबंधी विधेयक की तरह पारित कर दिया गया। अगर कोई विधेयक धन संबंधी विधेयक के रूप में लोकसभा में पारित किया जाता है तो संसद का उच्च सदन या राज्यसभा उस पर चर्चा तो कर सकती है पर उसमें संशोधन नहीं कर सकती। इसके साथ ही राज्यसभा को धन संबंधी विधेयक पर चर्चा भी तुरंत करानी पड़ती है क्योंकि राज्यसभा में पेश किए जाने के 14 दिन के भीतर अगर चर्चा नहीं होती तो उसे पारित मान लिया जाता है। आधार बिल 2016 के अंतर्गत यूनिक आइडेंटिफिकेशन नंबर या एकमात्र पहचान क्रमांक प्रोग्राम यानी आधार को कानूनी मान्यता दी गई है जिसका सब्सिडी और अन्य लाभ सीधे बांटने के लिए इस्तेमाल किया जाएगा। आधार विधेयक लोकसभा में पारित हो चुका है।
Now we take up Aadhaar Target Delivery of Financial and Other Subsidies, Benefits and Service Bill 2016. Sri Arun Jaitley to move.
Mr. Chairman, sir, the Aadhaar Targeted Delivery of Financial and Other Subsidies, Benefit and Services Bill 2016 has been transmitted to this House. Before I explain this bill, I'll also deal with the various kinds of points which have been raised. One argument which is raised is that the Supreme Court 5-judge bench is considering this issue and therefore the Parliament must suspend its own powers of legislation. It's an unprecedented argument, particularly in a democracy which is governed by the separation of powers. The power to legislate belongs to Parliament. The power to legislate doesn't belong to the court. And therefore, the court only has a power of judicial review. Before a legislation is framed, hold your hands and don't legislate is an unprecedented argument bound to be rejected. It's an unstatable argument. The history is that the government, and the government I take it as a continuing identity, decided by an executive decision to constitute the UID authority, and for some services UID was being made mandatory. Thereafter a bill was introduced in 2010 in this house. The bill was never passed. So the UID functioned as an executive authority without a law. The court may be concerned with different questions, and the principal challenge was that in the absence of any process or a due process, there is, on the prima facie, could be a violation of right of privacy, and therefore that challenge on the grounds of right of privacy is a right which is pending before a 5-judge bench of the court. Now let us first of all deal with this right of privacy. The Constitution as a document doesn't use the word privacy. So the constitutional text doesn't mention privacy as a fundamental right. The present bill presupposes and is based on a premise that it's too late in the day to contend that privacy is not a fundamental right. So I do accept that probably privacy is a fundamental right. Now, where do you fit in privacy as a fundamental right? Article 21 says, no person shall be deprived of his right of life and liberty without procedure established by law. So let us assume that privacy is a part of liberty. And no person shall be deprived of his privacy without procedure established by law. The underlying point is that privacy is not an absolute right. It's a right even in our constitution, if it's a fundamental right in Article 21, which is subject to a restriction that it can be restricted by a procedure established by law. Now, that procedure established by law obviously has to be a fair, just and reasonable procedure. The UPA legislation was that a UID authority will be created. A UID authority, there will be a procedure how the authority is created. There will be a procedure how personal details are taken and the storage of those personal details, the storage of those biometrics, and when can that information be shared and in what manner? What is the purpose of that information that was absent in the UPA law? The present law, compared to the UPA law, and I'll subsequently show it, demonstrate, there's a very strict procedure. The privacy law is much more tightened. And the core purpose of this law is that both center and state governments give several subsidies to people. Now, the purpose of these subsidies is that these have to be quantified amounts given to identifiable sections. If subsidies are given as unquantified amounts to unidentified section, then non-merit people will get the subsidies, the merit will not get it. And from the public exchequer, you will keep spending money, which doesn't go to the targeted people, which goes to the people who don't deserve subsidies. Therefore, the nature of this bill is, the core of this bill or the pith and substance of this bill is, that government monies are being spent by center and state governments. When you spend that money, in order to ensure that money reaches the right man, you insist on the identity of the person. And the other provisions in the bill are how that identity is going to be determined. Second, why is it a money bill? And that is a question that Mr. Naresh Agrawal raised. Article 110 defines what a money bill is. Subclause C of Article 110 is absolutely clear that if monies flow into the Consolidated Fund of India, and if monies are spent out of the Consolidated Fund of India, and a law in pith and substance deals with that matter, it becomes a money bill. What if that law has several other provisions? Will it cease to be a money bill? That's a question. Because Article 110 uses a word only if. The first Lok Sabha was confronted with this question, and Mr. Mavlankar clearly gave a ruling, the answer is no. It will remain a money bill if the principal purpose of that bill is to impose a tax and the incidental provisions. And if you now read Article 110C read with Article 110G, G means any other power incidental to the main purpose. So the purpose of the present bill is money spent out of the Consolidated Fund of India, which go towards the expenditure of subsidies, makes it a money bill. The administrative machinery around it makes it, under subclause G, a provision incidental to the administration of that money bill. And Article 110(3) clearly says, in this matter, it is the satisfaction of the Speaker of the Lok Sabha which is final, and since it is final,
we cannot discuss that.
Now comes the third question. How is this bill different from the one that the UPA brought in? The UPA bill, it wasn't a money bill. It was a bill only for the creation of a UID authority. That bill today stands altered. One principal idea is borrowed from that bill, that UID will be the machinery under which will be used for distribution of government money as subsidies. But the core purpose of the bill will be, how is money to be spent? And so that the money is spent in a targeted manner, it must reach the persons to whom the benefits are to be conferred. And those persons are, the persons who are entitled to the subsidies. In the LPG, where the direct benefit transfer has been used, 25% has been saved. These 5 crore families which will get it, is actually free gas connection, will get it from the money saved from this. State governments of Telangana, state governments of Andhra Pradesh, they have already started using this in several other other areas itself. So every state government will then be able to ensure that subsidies reach the right person itself. That's the whole object. And I have seen my good friend Jairam has proposed, along with some other members, several amendments to the bill. Most of those amendments are against the UPA bill itself. So what were the provisions of the UPA bill today are being damned by these amendments, and we have borrowed those ideas. Now, if you see the UPA law, and if you see it from Chapter 6, Clause 30 downwards, you had several provisions of confidentiality, and then you created a mechanism by which that confidentiality and privacy itself can be breached. The UPA law created this. The present law now restricts itself to two situations. A person by his consent can say that my personal data can be shared, so you need his consent. But his biometric data can't even be shared with consent. The core biometric data. So it's a much tighter provision. The UPA law spoke in terms of authorities which are created, which can then say that on grounds of mention in the bill, under special circumstances, some data can be shared. What have we done? The only ground on which data can be shared is national security. And who will decide that national security? One authority will be created in Delhi. That authority will be headed by an officer of a certain category. And then the decision of that authority will be reviewed by a committee headed by the cabinet secretary. And that sharing then is also time-bound. 3 months. Now, all these are safeguards additionally put over and above the UPA bill. Sir, in the United States, the Social Security number legislation was first created, which is an equivalent of Aadhaar, in 1935. So we are already 80 years behind times. And over 80 years, they've been adding. I have a list. For income tax, they made it compulsory. For some policies, they made it compulsory. For buying bonds, they made it compulsory. For a lot of economic activity, they made it compulsory. For possessing arms, they made it compulsory. So there is a list running into 10 pages where they kept expanding it from time to time. Now, this has helped them in matters of national security. Sir, the purpose of this bill is distribution of government monies by subsidies. Yes. The rest is incidental, so it's a money bill. Two, merely because executive action challenge is pending in the Supreme Court, this parliament cannot suspend its right to legislate. And three, learning from the UPA experience and the kind of debate which took place, we have further tightened the privacy laws much more than what the UPA had in its bill. And the only ground now is national security, which every member has to agree gives way to an individual's right, has to give way to national security, and therefore this House must accept the recommendation in relation to a money bill of the House of People.
No, you move the motion. Move the motion. You say you, I move the bill. I move the motion for consideration.
Sir, I move that the Aadhaar Targeted Delivery of Financial and Other Subsidies Benefit Services Bill 2016 be approved by the House.
आप बने रहिए हमारे साथ. हम लौटेंगे एक छोटे से ब्रेक के बाद. जारी है संसद संवाद.
बंगला बांग्लादेश या नेपाल से कोई आदमी यहाँ आ जाए तो क्या उसको आधार कार्ड बन जाएगा उसका? आखिर कितने दिन की एसएन चलती है? कैसे सर्टिफाई होगा इस देश का नागरिक?
चर्चा के दौरान सदस्यों ने आधार विधेयक 2016 को मनी बिल के रूप में पेश करने की वैधता पर सवाल खड़े किए। वित्त मंत्री ने स्पष्ट किया कि ये धन बिल है क्योंकि समाज कल्याण कार्यक्रमों पर आधार से जुड़ा प्रत्येक व्यय समेकित कोष यानी कंसोलिडेटेड फंड से जारी होता है। आधार के जरिए ही नकद सब्सिडी दी जाएगी जो सीधे लाभार्थियों के खाते में जमा होगी।
Now, yes, there are Ramesh.
Sir, I rise in considerable anguish to speak and support with amendments the Aadhaar Bill 2016. So yesterday we had the ritualistic obeisance to the importance of the Rajya Sabha. Today we are knocking a nail into the coffin of the upper house. I say this advisedly, sir, and I am sure that Lord Krishna had opposition members of the Rajya Sabha in mind when he advised Arjuna in chapter 2, Karmanye Vadhikaraste Ma Phaleshu Kadachana Ma Karma Phala Heturbhur Ma Te Sanghostu Karmani. I feel in the same situation today. I am executing only my duty, which is enjoined on me by Article 109 of the Constitution. As Union Rural Development Minister, I was the first one to use the Aadhaar idea, the Aadhaar number, in the payment of wages for Mahatma Gandhi Narega, the payment of pensions under the National Social Assistance Program, and for the delivery of food subsidies, beginning in East Godavari district of Andhra Pradesh and then taken up in Chittoor district. So I need no certificates or lectures on my commitment to Aadhaar. The Leader of the House has given a detailed exposition on why this is a money bill. Sir, Article 110, the word only, as the Honorable Leader of the House has mentioned, has special significance. Unfortunately, the former Attorney General of India, who is a nominated member of this House, is not present. And I spent long hours with him over the weekend. And he has given me a 10-page letter, a 10-page note, which I am willing to place on the table of the House, which argues that in pith and substance, the Aadhaar bill is not a money bill. However, sir, the Speaker's decision is final. We respect that decision. Much has been made in the Leader of the House's opening remarks on the LPG subsidy. And the main justification for the Aadhaar was the 14,000 crores saving in LPG subsidy in the first year of the introduction of the DBT, the Aadhaar-based DBT. So I have here a study that has been done by a London-based think tank called the International Institute for Sustainable Development, which says the following. Publicly available information clearly demonstrates that the Aadhaar-based DBT was not responsible for identifying and blocking 3.3 crore connections or even a significant fraction of that during any part of the financial year. Sir, the Honorable Leader of the House has compared the 2010 bill and the 2016 bill. I pleaded with the Chairman of the Standing Committee. The Prime Minister sent me to meet the Standing Committee members. I pleaded with them. But in 2010, sir, the Standing Committee vetoed the bill lock, stock, and barrel. I'm glad 6 years later, this government is coming forward with a different bill, similar in some respects, different in other aspects, but they're coming forward with this bill. I support the Aadhaar Bill. I want the Aadhaar Bill. But I am proposing some major amendments. So the fundamental departure on the Aadhaar Bill 2016 comes from a recognition that even today, Aadhaar must be used, but it must be voluntary. It must not be mandatory. Sir, Aadhaar does not determine who is eligible, who is not eligible. Please, let us get rid of this myth. Aadhaar is proof of identity. And I'm sure the Honorable Leader of the House agrees with me.
Then how is it a financial?
It's proof of identity. I'm 100% with the Honorable Leader of the House. This Aadhaar is a subsidy sudhar program because fakes, duplicates are a reality. Aadhaar by itself does not solve the problem. So let us understand what we are doing today. We must have legislation for Aadhaar. We must have legislation for the UID authority. But let us not go away from here that we have done subsidy sudhar, that we have somehow managed to solve the problem of delivering subsidies and wages and pensions. We have tackled one part of the issue, which is fake identity, duplicate identity. So the fundamental difference is on mandatory versus voluntary. We do not believe, and I do not believe, my party does not believe, that Aadhaar should be made mandatory across the board from day one. However, this bill, if you look at Clause 57, and if you look at Clause 7, certainly gives the interpretation and opens the door for mandatory use of the Aadhaar number. The bill is being bought to target subsidies. So let the bill be confined to the targeting of subsidies. Why? I don't have an Aadhaar number, sir. I don't have an Aadhaar number. And I don't need one. Because I am not a beneficiary of a subsidy. But tomorrow, if I were to want a mobile connection, if I were to go and buy an airline ticket, or if I were to go somewhere, and the guy says, where is your Aadhaar number? You made it mandatory, no? The whole idea of Aadhaar is subsidy reform. The whole idea of Aadhaar is to remove fake, duplicate identities, which we support. Now, I believe that if you read this legislation as currently drafted, it certainly widens the ambit of Aadhaar and certainly makes it a mandatory proposition as opposed to a voluntary proposition, which was the intention of the UPA from day one. So my next problem with this legislation is on the privacy aspect. In 2012, the then Planning Commission set up an expert committee under the chairmanship of Justice A.P. Shah, a former Chief Justice of the Delhi High Court, and a former chairman of the Law Commission. The Justice A.P. Shah committee enumerated a large number of principles which the Aadhaar legislation must follow to make it privacy compatible, and the amendments that I am proposing are basically anchored in the recommendations of the Justice A.P. Shah committee. Sir, the law as presently stands gives sweeping powers under the name of national security. The Indian Telegraph Act of 1885 does not use the word national security. It uses the word emergency, and public safety. And what I have suggested, what I am suggesting, is that we be consistent, because the word national security is very broad, very amorphous. It can be misused. We have seen how it is being misused. And what I am suggesting is that instead of national security, there should be public emergency and public safety. And what I am suggesting is that the presence of another independent member like the CVC or the CAG should also be there when the Aadhaar information is being shared in the name of public emergency and public safety. So, there are a number of clauses which gives the power to the UID authority under regulation. So this I am opposed to, we are opposed to collectively. Whatever must be done and passed by Parliament. So we want to reform the regime of subsidies. If you use Aadhaar properly, the government stands to save anywhere between 40 to 45,000 crores a year. That was an estimate that was made when Dr. Manmohan Singh was the Prime Minister. And that was the impetus, sir, that led to the creation of Aadhaar. I am going to move certain significant amendments. I hope to get the support of the House for these amendments. I am requesting you, refer it to a select committee. This is my humble request to the Honorable Leader of the House. Thank you, sir.
Dr. Chandan Mitra.
Thank you. This Aadhaar bill, a much better and qualitatively superior Aadhaar bill, has been brought by the NDA government under the leadership of Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi, who has improved upon the Aadhaar bill that was brought by the UPA. But now, this debate that has started about the purpose of the bill, so the purpose is twofold and they are related. This bill is intended to identify and enable people to draw funds from the Consolidated Fund of India, to which the government will transfer directly. I again want to recall former Prime Minister and a leader of the Congress Party, the late Sri Rajiv Gandhi, had once said the very famous thing, which I'm sure everybody here knows, that of every rupee that goes out from Delhi, only 15 paisa reaches people in the villages. 85 paisa is siphoned on the way. What does the Aadhaar bill intend to do? It wants to stop the siphoning of money midway. This is the biggest, I would say, service that Aadhaar is doing.
Naresh ji,
main Shri Jairam Ramesh ji aur other hamare friends jinhone amendments rakhe hain, un amendments ke paksh mein bolne ke liye kaha. Shriman, humne shuru mein objection uthaya, ye money bill nahi ho sakta hai. Shriman, kyon ye money bill bana ke laye? Isse inki isi aashanka se hum logo ko shanka bani hui hai. कि एक बिल को जो जनरल बिल था उसको ये मनी बिल अगर बना रहे हैं तो इसके मतलब कहीं ना कहीं पीछे पर्दे के कोई खेल है. इस देश में सिवन जब वोटर आईडी बनने की बात आई थी, इलेक्शन कमीशन ने कहा था कि वोटर आईडी जरूर बनना चाहिए, तब भी ये बात आई थी कि वोटर आईडी जो है वो पूरे वर्ल्ड में मान्यता रखेगा जिसकी वोटर आईडी बन जाएगी. लेकिन यहाँ तो जब वोटर आईडी बनी तो मालूम पड़ा वोटर लिस्ट में नाम नहीं है वोटर आईडी हमारे पास. और अगर वोटर आईडी लेके हम गए, वोटर लिस्ट में नाम नहीं था तो हमको वोट डालने नहीं दिया. और कितना रुपया उस पर खर्च हुआ का मैं जानना चाहता हूँ कि आधार जो कार्ड बन रहे हैं इस कार्ड पर कुल कितना इन्वेस्ट हो रहा है और किसको ओवलाइज किया गया ये भी पता होना चाहिए. ये किसी को ओवलाइज करने के लिए तो नहीं किया जाए. अगर इन्होंने इसको मैंडेटरी कर दिया तो कल अगर हमारे पास पैन कार्ड है, बर्थडे सर्टिफिकेट है, वोटर आईडी है, बैंक की पासबुक है, ये कह देंगे सब बेकार. अगर आपके पास आधार कार्ड नहीं है तो आप इस देश के नागरिक भी नहीं. कल अगर बांग्लादेश या नेपाल से कोई आदमी यहाँ आ जाए तो क्या उसको आधार कार्ड बन जाएगा उसका? आखिर कितने दिन की एसेंशियलिटी है? कैसे सर्टिफाई होगा कि इस देश का नागरिक है? कौन सर्टिफाई करेगा उसको आधार कार्ड बनाने से पहले? कहीं उन्होंने तो उसको बताया नहीं. और सुप्रीम कोर्ट के अंदर का विचाराधीन है, कहीं ऐसा ना हो कि सुप्रीम कोर्ट की पांच जजों की बेंच इसको रिजेक्ट कर दे और इस पर पैसा खर्च हो जाए. तुम्हारे मैं फिर से जयराम रमेश जी के द्वारा जो संशोधन प्रस्तुत किए हैं उन पर बल देता हूं और मैं चाहूंगा उस पर वोटिंग हो जिससे कि सही चीज जनता के बीच.
सदस्यों ने माना कि पंजीकरण के दौरान निवासी की डेमोग्राफिक और बायोमेट्रिक जानकारी जुटाई जाती है जिसे साझा करने से निजता के अधिकार का हनन होता है. सरकार का कहना है कि आधार में जानकारियों की पर्याप्त सुरक्षा व्यवस्था की गई है. विधेयक के तहत निजी सूचनाओं को संबंधित व्यक्ति की सहमति से ही साझा किया जा सकता है। लाभार्थी की सहमति होने पर भी मुख्य बायोमेट्रिक सूचनाओं को साझा नहीं किया जा सकता। इसके साथ ही इसमें किसी तरह की चोरी पर सजा का भी प्रावधान है। विधेयक में निजी सूचना को साझा किए जाने का एकमात्र आधार राष्ट्रीय सुरक्षा है। चर्चा के अगले और आखिरी अंक में हम जानेंगे बाकी सदस्यों की राय और वित्त मंत्री अरुण जेटली का जवाब। नमस्कार।
Clause 7 of the bill makes Aadhaar registration compulsory in order to avail subsidies, benefits or services from the central government. So at this juncture, a substantial number of people in India are not enrolled in Aadhaar. Until we achieve universal coverage, how can Aadhaar be made mandatory?